recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslim's pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wal aqibatu lil muttaqin. Wa la udwana illa ala al-zalimin. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidil awwalin wal akhirin nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa ba'd. Dear brothers and sisters everywhere, welcome to a new edition of your program, Correct Recitation. Inshallah, today we will begin a new chapter. This is chapter number 75 in the order of the Quran. It is called AlQiyamah. It consists of 40 verses. AlQiyamah is also one of the names of the Day of Judgment, which means resurrection. Qama is to be resurrected, to stand up, to resurrect. AlQiyamah is the resurrection. So we understand from that most likely that must be a Makki surah. It will be speaking about the Day of Judgment, the hereafter, life after death, the fate of the believers versus the non-believers. And that's why the theme refers to the chapter as a Makki chapter. It has been revealed before the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of course, as usual, we would kindly request Sheikh Ismail to begin reciting from the beginning of Surah AlQiyamah through verse number 19. But before that, I would like indeed to welcome Sheikh Ismail himself and the rest of our studio guests. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Sheikh Ismail, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيره لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه.
بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خيرا يا شيخ اسماعيل. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة القيامة. Before we indulge into the meaning and the interpretation of these verses from 1 to 19, I would like to take you in a journey with our word bank to recognize the meaning of very important vocabulary in these verses so that we'll be able to comprehend the meaning inshallah. The first word we have, and I thought it would be very interesting to discuss, is an-nafs al-lawwama. We must have heard the word an-nafs several times. The word nafs means the soul, but al-lawwama is an extensive form from al-lawm, which is blaming or reproaching. An-nafs al-lawwama literally means the self-reproaching person. The self-reproaching person, the person who blames himself for his or her shortcomings. They blame themselves for not perfecting their actions, their deeds. And we'll be speaking in details, inshallah, about this kind of soul. The second word is banana. Al-banan means the fingertips. Banana, this is the ha of the pronoun. بَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَهُ. We are definitely able to perfect his fingertips once again on the day of resurrection. The next word is لِيَفْجُرَ. This is in verse number 5. بَلْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنسَانُ لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَهُ. لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَهُ, that a man wants to continue in following their desires, in committing sins, in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in doing whatever their whims and desires incline them to. Why? Because a person does not believe in the hereafter. So he believes, this is it, that is the only life that I'm going to live. So let me do whatever I can do in this life. Ayyana يسأل أيان يوم القيامة. أيان means when. When will it take place? The non-believer keeps asking, when will the day of resurrection happen? أيان means متى, when. And the word بارقا, فإذا بارق البصر, which means is dazzled or dazed. The sight will be dazed. وخسف, الخسف or الخسوف means eclipse. That's why we have in Arabic a prayer for the خسوف of the moon and the كسوف of the sun, which is the moon and the sun eclipse, which means خسف القمر, that the moon will be dark. One of the most important significance of the moon, it reflects the light of the sun on earth. That's why it provides us with light at night. So imagine when the moon becomes entirely dark as well, and that will happen on the day of judgment. The word wazar in kalla la wazar, nay, there will not be any refuge. So the word wazar means literally refuge or shelter in order to hide in. The word wazr in the Arabic language also means a mountain or a cave where a person enters in order to hide or to spend the night. Al-mustaqar ila rabbika yawma idin al-mustaqar. In verse number 12, the place of rest and settlement. It's a permanent residence. It is a dwelling place eternally. إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمُسْتَقَرِ. The word basira in the verse بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا, verse number 14, means a witness. Every man will be a witness against or for himself. And the evidence which will make a person convicted will stem from within himself. As we discussed before, when the person would deny any testimony of any person, including the angels who recorded his deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept that he will deliver the testimony himself. When he will say, لَا أَرْضَى شَاهِدًا عَلَى نَفْسِي إِلَّا مِن نَفْسِي. I would only accept a witness from myself, not from others. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seal up his mouth, paralyze his tongue, then would allow his body parts to speak out, to bear witness. The skin will be able to speak out, the eyes, the hearing, the hands, the feet, and so on. Ma'adhirah in verse number 15, walau alqa ma'adhirah means excuses. The person will try to give excuses in order to cover up his evil deeds. Qur'ana literally means from Quran. Obviously, Quran means the most frequently recited book, and Qur'ana means its recitation, from qara'a or recited. Okay. So far, that is the words that we have till verse number 19. And now let's start by learning the meanings of these verses and the interpretation, insha'Allah Azza Jalla. As we said before, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore, and we studied many chapters in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore by some of his creatures, in order to bring to our attention either the value and the significance of what he has created, and his magnificent ability in creating things, or in order to bring to our attention the danger of what he is swearing to. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة, I swear by the day of judgment, the day of resurrection. Literally, al-qiyamah means the resurrection. So la in the beginning is like, it is not as what you guys think. The Meccan pagans and the non-believers thought that there will not be a day of resurrection. In here, illa hayatuna ad-dunya namutu wa nahya wa ma nahnu bimab'uthin. This is what they kept saying. It's only this life we live, then we die, and it's over. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, la, nay, it is not as what you think. Uqusimu biyawm al-qiyamah, I swear by the day of resurrection, which signifies that there will be certainly a day of resurrection. وَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ, the second oath Allah is swearing to or by the reproaching self or soul. What is the meaning of the self-reproaching person? The Quran talks about three types of nafs. In Surah Yusuf, the wife of the Egyptian prime minister who tried to seduce Prophet Joseph, peace be upon him, when it was time to confess her sin, she said, وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. She said, I'm not setting myself free from the sins, because the self, the soul, is inclined naturally into evil, except for oneself, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy on, because he is of forgiven, the most merciful. So everybody's soul is inclined naturally into sinning and evil, except for those whom Allah guides. May Allah make us amongst them. So this is an-nafsul ammara, the soul which orders the person to commit sins and to disobey. An-nafsul ammara bisu. And definitely this is a dispraised soul or nafs in the Quran. The second nafs is mentioned in Surah AlQiyamah. I'm taking it in order. So Surah Yusuf, then Surah AlQiyamah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ, which means I swear by the self-reproaching person or by the soul which blames itself. If somebody went to sleep without praying, which he cannot sleep, he keeps blaming himself. How could I do that? There are others whom if they do not offer the night prayer, they will not be able to sleep. Rather, they will keep blaming themselves. So it is not only self-reproaching because they commit sins. No, it's both ways. Either because the person has committed a sin, so he blames himself. How could I do that? How could I disobey my Lord? This is nafs lawama. Or in a higher level, where a person misses something that he normally does in order to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether of the voluntary deeds pertaining salah, zakah, charity, or dhikr. So he says, how could I skip that? So he blames himself that he did not do something that was good and he was able to do it. النفس اللوامة is praiseworthy, and it is praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he said, I swear by such nafs, bin nafs al-lawama. And a person who would have this nafs would resort to repentance whenever he or she commits sins. And this is an act that is praiseworthy by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and loved by him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Verily, Allah loves those who frequently repent unto Him and those who frequently purify themselves. One of the conditions for acceptance one's repentance is to regret. To regret committing the sin. To feel sorry that you've done it. This is the task and the function of an-nafsu al-lawwama, or the self-reproaching nafs. أيحسب الإنسان ألا نجمع عظامه. Before I talk about that, I must not forget the third type of nafs that was mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-Fajr, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فدخلي في عبادي ودخلي جنتي. This is a soul which is well-pleasing and well-pleased by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. It will be asked to enter among the righteous servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to enter into Allah's mercy and to His paradise. And also, at the time of death, when the angels of death are extracting and taking out this nafs out of one's body, they would assure that person, come to the mercy of Allah. Come to maghfiratin min Allah wa ridwan, to forgiveness and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the pleasure. Obviously, one cannot obtain this nafs towards the end of life or in the hereafter unless if he maintained a nafs al-lawwama throughout his entire life. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us aware of our deeds, make us account and recount ourselves on a daily basis, on a regular basis, so that inshallah, at the time of death, then on the day of judgment, we will be amongst an-nafs al-mutma'inna. أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّا نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ. It's like there is an oath, and now we're waiting for the subject of the oath, the answer to the oath. That al-insan, he is referring to the insan who is a disbeliever, who disbelieves in the day of judgment and in the reality of resurrection. Does he think that we shall not assemble his bones? If you remember in the past, more than a year ago, we talked about Surah Yasin, and we said that one of the Meccan pagans brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a decayed bone, a rotten bone. Then he rubbed it between his fingers. It turned into dust. And he said, Ya Muhammad, do you claim that your Lord will be able to bring the ashes of this bone into life once again? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered, most certainly saying, Bala. Certainly he will. Not only that, but he will cause you to die. Then he will resurrect you. Then finally he will throw you in fire as a result of not believing in the resurrection. There are many ahadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whenever he wanted to order us to do something and encourage us to do it or abstain from doing something and warn us against, he says, "Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawmil akhir." They are always attached, never inseparable from each other. Belief in Allah, in His oneness, and belief in the last day, in the day of resurrection. That's why people do good, and that's why people abstain from doing bad, because there will be a day of reckoning, a day of accountability. مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلِيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. While I'm talking, I'm about to backbite somebody, then I remember, well, there will be a day of judgment. I better not indulge into this conversation. I better not get sucked in such dialogue. Somebody is about to steal, somebody is about to commit whatever sin, then he remembers that there will be a hisab. As Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, used to say, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. Hold yourself accountable before you be held accountable. Then بلى certainly قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا. You guys, the non-believers, you are in doubt with regards to the resurrection and reassembling the bones. Certainly we are most able to put together imperfect, not just the bones, البنان, the tips of the fingers, including the fingerprints. And we all know that this is a magnificent creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that no one's fingerprints resemble anybody else, from the very first to the very last, because this is a creator. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It did not happen haphazardly. As those who still until today either believe in the Big Bang and it happened as an accident, that all of us were created due to an accident, or those who still drink and the urine of a cow as a means of blessing and consider as sacred objects which Allah created, including lifeless objects, these guys have to understand that what about the fingerprints? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as I created them, very unique, every person has his own unique fingerprints, then I am certainly able and I will put together in perfect the fingerprints of every person on the Day of Judgment. So that we will not be only resurrected as images or something similar to what we were in the dunya. No, the same exact creation, including the fingertips. This is really amazing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَلْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنسَانُ لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَهُ. Why would a person deny the resurrection in the Day of Judgment? Because he desires to continue committing sins. So when you remind him that fear Allah, there will be a Day of Judgment, once I met somebody who is about to commit a major sin, then I told him, I advised him kindly and enjoying what's right, and I tried to forbid the bad that he was about to do. He said, you know what, you better not talk to me. I just gave sleeping pills to my conscience, and I don't want anyone to awaken me. Belief in the reality of Day of Judgment is an awakening call. It reminds you that nothing will be forgotten, nothing will be wasted. Whatever you commit, whether of good or bad, will be recorded. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوا. That's why those who disbelieve in the Day of Judgment, they tend to disbelieve in it, so that they can continue to do what they desire freely. يَسْأَلُ أَيَّانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. This question is in a sarcastic way, in a sarcastic fashion. He asks, when will the Day of Resurrection happen? When will it take place? وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. They continue to say, when is it, if you are telling the truth? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers in the Quran in many positions that its knowledge is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. In these ayat, in Surah AlQiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers differently. He says, you want to know when will this day take place? فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرِ. When the sight shall be dazed and dazzled. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when the soul comes out of the body, it will be followed by the sight. That's why those who die, they will be looking up. If they are lying on their deathbed, you see their eyes and their eyeballs will go up. تَبِعَهَا الْبَصَرِ. The sight will follow the soul. The person will be seeing and examining his soul coming out of his body. Very interesting. فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرِ وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرِ. Amongst the major and mass destruction which will take place on the Day of Judgment, we spoke about that in details in Surah Al-Takwir, in Surah Al-Infitar, in these ayat which talk about the Day of Judgment, there will be khusuf, major khusuf. Now in the dunya, when we have the moon eclipse or the sun eclipse, people go out to take pictures and celebrate and so on, while Muslims have to resort to the prayer, because it reminds us with the biggest fear, with the day of resurrection, with the day of judgment. It reminds us, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. It reminds us, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ. It reminds us, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْشَقَّتْ. It reminds us with all of that. So we rush to pray, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ. And the moon will be eclipsed, and it will be dark. وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ. The sun and the moon will be folded together because they don't have functions anymore. We don't want you anymore. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fold them. يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر. The same insan who was mentioned in the beginning in verse number 3. أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه. Now he's a believer. Now he recognizes and acknowledges the truth. This is indeed the day of judgment. الإنسان will say أين المفر. Where can I hide? Is there any shelter? Is there a place to hide? From whom? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. When somebody was addicted to a particular sin and was speaking to his friend, he said, well, let me advise you. In order to commit sins freely and not to worry about the consequences, you need to do three things. Number one, make sure that you do it somewhere where you hide from Allah. He cannot see you. Second, make sure that you disobey him, or when you disobey him, you do not disobey him on his territory, on his property. Find another ard, another earth where you can disobey him. And make sure that you disobey him under a sky which is not his. He said, where can I find that? He said, well, if everywhere belongs to Allah, and no matter wheresoever you are, wheresoever you're hiding, you're being seen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you should feel ashamed of yourself if you challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by sinning while you know that you are living on his property, sheltered by his sky, and seen by him 24/7. Well, the last verse in today's, in this segment is كَلَّا لَا وَزَرْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَ إِذِنِ الْمُسْتَقَرِ. Definitely there is no refuge on the day unto your Lord will be the place of rest. Then on the day al-insan will be informed by what he or she has sent forward, whether good or bad, and what he has left behind, whether good or bad. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أحصاه الله ونسوه. We forget a lot, but it is all recorded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it will be spread in a sheet before all of us. The role of our deeds will be spread before us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us what's best, and to make us love obeying him, and to set us free from our whims and desires. Let's take a short break, and inshallah we'll start reciting together after this break in the next segment. Stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
You've seen him on the righteous companions. You've seen him on the inevitable journey. We want the Muslim home to be a Muslim home.
You have 30 episodes to teach us how to build a better future. Ready, set, go.
And all of these are ideas. Yeah. We got to be creative.
What are our tools? Bubblegum, Mickey Mouse, Starbucks, American movies, foreign films. Is this going to produce a good generation of Muslims?
In order to produce that generation, Malik,
yes,
there are three institutions.
That generation, we want to produce that generation to be those men. Sisters, go back to the religion, go back to your deen.
We're talking about the next generation. You're going to hear me say that phrase a lot, the next generation. I'm not talking about Star Trek. We had this chart, Sheikh, that had, it shows a small monkey, and then like a bigger monkey, and a bigger monkey.
That new generation, that better future. Even in the West, they say a family that prays together stays together.
This, what is the Sunnah? Sunnah is actually the method or the way or the practice of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. In this new edition, we will tackle many Sunnah. And I'll start, inshallah, with the sunnah of the wudu. That we Muslim, as we also commanded by Allah and the Messenger of Allah to take care of the Quran, follow the Quran and implement the Quran, we also being commanded by Allah and the Messenger of Allah to implement and follow the sunnah. Some of the people said, what does it make different whether I drink with my right hand or left hand? The difference is you are disobeying Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it is also a very recommended sunnah. One of the obligation on me as a Muslim toward my brothers is to visit him when he's sick. You know, believe it or not, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us everything, even how do you go to the toilet. The sunnah of sneezing, that when you sneeze, you should cover your mouth and nose with your cloth or a handkerchief or a tissue or anything.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to this segment. Let me remind you with our phone numbers. They also should appear on the screen. Code 002-0288-248 or 249. And we already have Sister Zainab from Nigeria on the phone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Sister Zainab, we're reciting today from the beginning of Surah AlQiyamah through verse number 19. Please.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. La uqsimu bi yawmil qiyamah wa la uqsimu billahi lawwamah. أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظاما بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا
على أن نسوي بنانا
بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أماما يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيرة لا تهرج به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه.
Barakallahu fiki. Sister Zainab from Nigeria, that was great. MashaAllah. Thank you so much. And it seems like it's a Nigeria day. Okay. We have also a Sister Faiza from Kuwait. Assalamu alaikum. How are you?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah.
Okay. Let's go ahead and read from the beginning of Surah Al-Qiyamah, please.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظاما بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر
إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيره لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه.
بارك الله فيك حسبك. Thank you so much. جزاكم الله خيرا. We have brother Qadhaf. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to correct your citation. Again from the beginning of Surah AlQiyamah, please. Qadhaf, are you there? Assalamu alaikum. Okay, please try again. It seems like you have a problem in the phone line. We lost Brother Qazif's call. We have Dino. Would like to begin from Surah Al-Qiyamah, and we would like to pay attention to the characteristics of the letters as we studied before. We can do that here while we are in the studio versus if somebody is on the phone. Please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا بنق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر.
بارك الله فيك. We'll come back to speak about when we stopped at the word أين المفر and the ruling of the راء in this condition whether the تفخيم or otherwise. Okay, we have Najla. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the program. From the beginning of Surah Al-Qiyamah, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. La uqsimu bi yawmil qiyamah wa la uqsimu bin nafsil lawwamah. أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه.
Can we reread verse number 3 please?
أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه.
Okay, we've got two things here. Your reading inshallah is great. But pay attention to number one, the qalqala, of course, on the letter jim, because it revives these letters. So the qalqala makes the letter alive. Versus when you say najma'a, I feel that we killed it. Then, when we have two vowel letters meeting, then each letter shall be pronounced clearly, and there is izhar in this case. The ayn, by the end of the word najma, it is vowel with the zabar, and the ayn in the beginning of the word izama is vowel with the zair. So it is not right to merge them together. There is no such idgham here. So rather we should say najma izama. This is with a slow motion, of course. So I will say, أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّن نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ. Okay? Sister Nagla, are you there?
Yes.
Please repeat the verse.
أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّن نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ أَلَّن نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ.
Wonderful. Great. Continue, please.
أَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَهُ بَلْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنسَانُ لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَهُ يَسْأَلُ أَيَّانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر.
I like the meme. I like the way you read the meme in verse number 10. أين المفر. I like the way you pronounce the meme here. But I would like to hear the meme of the word القمر the same in verse number 9. Can you repeat it, please? وَجُمِعَ
الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ.
Okay. We got two letters of tafkhim, the qaf and the ra.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
In the middle, there is a thin letter, the mean. So you have to pay extra attention to that letter. So we'll say
والقمر.
بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خيرا سيستر نجلاء. أحمد from Qatar, and thank you for waiting for so long. أحمد.
السلام عليكم شيخ.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. Go ahead and read from the beginning, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه.
Separate the two عينز. نجمع عظامه.
أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه.
Okay.
بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر.
I for some reason, of course there is reason, I don't like to hear القمر because the name is thin. القمر. And I would like Sheikh Ismail to read these two verses again. وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ. So that we can learn from him.
وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ.
You see, it's easy. قَمَا. قَمَا. Okay, can you continue please, Ahmed? وَخَسَفَ.
وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر.
Barakallahu fiq, Ahmed. Thank you so much. Qadhaf is back on the line. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How are you, brother?
Alhamdulillah.
Go ahead and recite from the beginning of Surah AlQiyamah, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim.
الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظاما بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانا بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أماما يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ مستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرا ولو ألقى معاذيرا لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنا فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنا ثم إن علينا بيانا
بارك الله فيك قذاف where did you learn reading? Was it in Sudan?
Nigeria.
Yeah. You're pretty much affected with the Sudani rhythm of reading the Quran. Thank you, Qadhaf. Anyway, and if we notice, I was talking about the Ra from verse number 7 all the way through verse number 13. These verses end up with the letter Ra. So sometimes, the person may not pronounce the Ra at all. Just get close to its articulation point because it's towards the end. Or some others, like sometimes Qadhaf, did pronounce it really as Muraqqaqa. So we want to make sure that we say فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ The Ra has to be clearly. This is the verification of this letter. وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر The Ra has to be heard. بارك الله فيكم. I guess we do not have any time left. I was just told that we ran out of time, unfortunately. Time whenever we read in the Quran and learning about the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zips by very fast. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all and make all this time and effort in the scale of our good deeds. Allahumma ameen. And until next time of correct your citation, I leave you in the care of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span. Sent from Allah to an angel, then to man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle. Recite the Quran.
بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيره لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأنا
is the ha of the pronoun بلا قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه we are definitely able to perfect his fingertips once again on the day of resurrection. The next word is liyafjura. This is in verse number 5. بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه. ليفجر أمامه, that a man wants to continue in following their desires, in committing sins, in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in doing whatever their whims and desires incline them to. Why? Because a person does not believe in the hereafter. So he believes, this is it, that is the only life that I'm going to live. So let me do whatever I can do in this life. أَيَّانَ يَسْأَلُ أَيَّانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ أَيَّانَ means when. When will it take place? The non-believer keeps asking, when will the day of resurrection happen? Ayana means mata, when. And the word bariqa, فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرِ, which means is dazzled or dazed. The sight will be dazed. وَخَسَفَ الْخَسْف or
and sisters to increase your iman read the miracle recite the Quran recite it every day and do read it loud the verses of Quran are all Muslims pride this miracle was revealed over a long time span sent from Allah an angel then to man that man was Muhammad the best of creation
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد Dear brothers and sisters everywhere, welcome to a new edition of your program, Correct Your Recitation. Inshallah, today we will begin a new chapter. This is chapter number 75 in the order of the Quran. It is called Al-Qiyamah. It consists of 40 verses. Al-Qiyamah is also one of the names of the Day of Judgment, which means resurrection. Qama is to be resurrected, to stand up, to resurrect.
القيامه فاتبع قرانه ثم ان علينا بيانه
بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا يا شيخ اسماعيل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سوره القيامه Before we indulge into the meaning and the interpretation of these verses from 1 to 19, I would like to take you on a journey with our word bank to recognize the meaning of very important vocabulary in these verses so that we'll be able to comprehend the meaning, inshallah. The first word we have, and I thought it would be very interesting to discuss, is an-nafs al-lawwama. We must have heard the word an-nafs several times. The word nafs means the soul, but al-lawwama is an extensive form from al-lawm, which is blaming or reproaching. An-nafs al-lawwama literally means the self-reproaching person. The self-reproaching person, the person who blames himself for his or her shortcomings. They blame themselves for not perfecting their actions, their deeds. And we'll be speaking in details, inshallah, about this kind of soul. The second word is banana. Al-banan means the fingertips. Banana, this is the resurrection. So we understand from that most likely that must be a Makki surah. It will be speaking about the day of judgment, the hereafter, life after death, the fate of the believers versus the non-believers. And that's why the theme refers to the chapter as a Makki chapter. It has been revealed before the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of course, as usual, we would kindly request Sheikh Ismail to begin reciting from the beginning of Surah AlQiyamah through verse number 19. But before that, I would like indeed to welcome Sheikh Ismail himself and the rest of our studio guests. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Sheikh Ismail, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه